right, no, but seriously, today I wanted to talk about the low-density secondary ability only found on the Weezing and Galarian Weezing line, known as Neutralizing Gas. Much like other very niche abilities like Corrosion on Salazzle or Flare Blue's Driftbloom, as of right now, Gen 8 Sword and Shield, Neutralizing Gas is the only available as secondary ability for the Coughing and Wheezing line. So what is Neutralizing Gas? For those who are not familiar with Neutralizing Gas, its ability suppresses the abilities of other Pokemon, with the exception of the obvious game-breaking mechanics of, say, Aegislash not being able to change stances, Wishiwashi not being able to go into its school form, or Silvally not having a type. So why does this matter? In a meta that is heavily dominated by Surge users, Weather, and Turn 1 item procs, battles can be tipped heavily in one favor or the other right outside of the Pokeball. I myself have been guilty of running Electric Surge Pincurchin and Electric Seed Hitmonlee as a check to Steam Engine Colossal and Justified Kobalion and Terrakion. The Turn 1 item proc combined with Unburdened Hitmonlee ensures Hitmonlee can outspeed and punch a substantial hole in most of the meta's common threats, while slightly increasing his survivability. Neutralizing Gas is an indirect counter to these strategies. Neutralizing Gas suppresses Surge, Weather, and Turn 1 item procs so long as Weezing stays on the field. With the introduction to Pokemon VGC Series 6 ban list, which the top 10 most used Pokemon will be omitted from ranked formats starting September 1st to October 31st, basically up until the release of the Clown Tundra, we saw some of the most common and effective strategies removed from Wi-Fi battle. But with every potent strategy, removing one Pokemon from the mix, regardless of how small the Sword and Shield decks may not completely nerf the strategy itself into complete unviability. New and even some old reliables from previous games are staking out their spot as new meta powerhouses. At some point in time, whether next season or possibly even new generation or remake, these Pokemon and their strategies will return. Neutralizing Gas denies all of these strats as well, so long as Weezing can stay on the field. Moving to our first two culprits, starting with our resident Surge users, Rillaboom and Indeedee. Rillaboom packs a massive 125 base attack stat with good bulk to match, and could easily be geared up with Choice Band, Grassy Seed, or Life Orb. With access to 70 base power stab priority move with Grassy Glide, or deal respectable damage proccing its own Grassy Seed, combined with Acrobatics and Max Airstream, not to mention its access to Fake Out combined with Normal Gem, and staples like Knock Off, U-Turn, Taunt, pipe hitters like Woodhammer, Superpower, Hammer Arm, and High Horsepower, it's no mystery Rillaboom got a lot of play. Moving on to Indeedee, and specifically the female Indeedee, Psychic Surge, which gets access to the priority move Follow Me. Now overall, looking at this Pokemon spread and move pool, it's really nothing special. But with the recent addition of the move Expanding Force paired with Alakazam, suddenly it becomes the hallmark of HP Melting, Fire and Forget, definitely outplayed meta. Moving on to the next set of goons, Torkoal, Venusaur, Sunny Day, Chlorophyll combo. Because 160 base speed Sleep Powder with the bulk and coverage to match is a no-brainer. Venusaur, debatably the strongest Mon with access to Chlorophyll with its base 100 special attack and special defense, strong Gigantamax form with both access to Stab, Max Ooze, and oppressive Vine Lash, coupled with the closest thing to a hidden power in the form of Weather Ball and Sunny Day, topping it off to checking most fire types with an Earth Power or Max Quake to boost its already respectable special defense, makes Venusaur an absolute unit when paired with Torkoal and Sunny Day. Torkoal definitely slaps in his own right. Its base 20 speed actually works out in favor due to it typically moving last. Torkoal is more often than not going to steal away Weather from its counterparts Politoed or Tyranitar, or even Abomasnow. Its access to Stealth Rock, Rapid Spin, Yawn, Clear Smog, and Will-O-Wisp make Torkoal a top tier utility, and although its special attack is only 85, the fact that it can use a Stab, Lava Plume, Heat Wave, and Eruption while having a massive 140 base defense and access to Body Press, Torkoal really does not have any issues dishing out formidable damage. However, Drought still exists in the faster frail Ninetales and can be easily paired up with other threatening Chlorophyll users like Leafeon, Tangrowth, and Shiftree, and the more common Gigantamax Charizard sporting Solar Power. Heliolisk is another interesting Solar Power user, and although not as common, could potentially be on the rise in the absence of other Pokemon. On the flip side of the Sun coin, of course, there is our Sandstorm users, in the form of both Sandstream Tyranitar and Hippoden, often paired with Sandrush Excadrill. I won't beat a dead horse on this one, because Sandstorm and Sandrush behave exactly like Sun and Chlorophyll would, but with the absence of Tyranitar and Hippo, it's no surprise to see Gigalith make a return in tandem with other threatening Sandrush users, and even some Sandvale teams with the impending return of big threats like Garchomp. Lastly, we have Dragapult and Whimsicott. I would classify them as top-tier setup Pokemon that are commonly used in support to set up specific Pokemon strategies. Dragapult was pretty infamous for using its insane 142 base speed stat to set up Weakness Policy, Steam Engine, Colossal, or Beat Up to set up Justified, Kabalion, Terrakion, or even Lucario, while falling back on its respectable 120 base attack to be a valid threat in its own right. Similar to Dragapult, we have Whimsicott. With its base 116 speed stat, with also access to Prankster, made it a potent user for setting up Tailwind, but also not limited to using moves like Beat Up, Helping Hand, Sunny Day, Taunt, or even Trick Room. With the exception of Surf or Follow Me, Whimsicott is probably one of the most perfect support mons in the business. Whimsicott has quickly shifted to Gale Wing's Talonflame, and with justified threats still existing in Wi-Fi battles, their setup users are being replaced with other fast Pokemon. The looming question surrounding Weezing, in my opinion, would be, how do we keep Weezing alive? Who do we add to build a team comp around Weezing and neutralizing gas? Who benefits from neutralizing gas? Our first candidate for a neutralizing gas team is of course Slaking. Although currently not included in the decks at the moment, Slaking would be a killer addition to the ability denied environment. Slaking's ability Truant, skipping every other turn, is definitely the yin to the yang of having some Goliath base stats. Slaking as of Gen 7 gained access to utility moves like Yawn, Taunt, Sucker Punch, Slack Off for Sustain, Roar, Quash, Encore, Bulk Up, and Amnesia, while having a potent physical move pool like Stab, Double Edge, and Body Slam, as well as Aerial Ace, Dynamic Punch, Earthquake, Gunk Shock, Hammer Arm, Play Rough, Rock Slide, Shadow Claw, and the Elemental Punches. He will certainly go far with his 160 base attack stat. As a Dynamax, having access to both Airstream, Max Knuckle, and Stab Max Strike, it's obvious that Slaking has the bulk to take hits and dish it back out with little effort. I can see Slaking rocking an Assault Vest to facilitate its already insane bulk at the cost of utility moves, potentially a Life Orb to squeeze more power out of Dynamax moves, especially after one Max Strike. It's likely Slaking will be outspeeding most of the Pokemon with a beneficial nature. The Therimon can go on for days, but I'm hoping we can all see the return of Slaking and run train in a neutralizing gas environment. Similar to our Slaking build, I can't ignore the Regigigas in the room. With the return and addition of new Regis, there's a fair chance Regigigas could be making its return to the decks. Regigigas is outfitted with an abysmally terrible ability, Slow Start, in which the first 5 turns Regi is on the field, both its attack and speed stat are halved. Although its superior bulk in having a base stat of 110 for HP, defense, and special defense are left unscathed, neutralizing gas could potentially turn this annoying, slow-moving tank into a significant offensive force. As of Gen 7, Regigigas gained access to utility moves like Block, Confuse Ray, Substitute, Wide Guard, Thunder Wave, and Double Team, and employs its Chad 160 base attack stat into stab moves like Giga Impact, Stomp for the 30% flinch hacks, and Strength for those who want to keep it 100 and get the best bang for their buck with checking accuracy or not wanting to recharge. Having access to Aerial Ace, Earthquake, Iron Head, Drain Punch, and Stone Edge give access to the powerful Dynamax move counterparts. I could see this set going full investment in either defense or special defense with Max Steel Spike or Max Quake to boost and set up its already insane bulk. Easily slap some leftovers on, or maybe an Assault Vest if you're willing to live without the Thunder Wave, or go full offensive, which I think is the more likely course of action in order to keep Weezing alive on the field. Our last addition to the Gas Gang is our Flying Fossil friend who made its debut back in Generation 5, Black and White, Archaeops. Archaeops moves fast and hits hard, with not the worst overall survivability or typing. Archaeops' ability, Defeatist, has always been its limiting factor in competitive play. While this Pokemon has half or less of its max HP, its attack and special attack are halved. Archaeops is outfitted with a 140 base attack stat, 112 special attack stat, and 110 base speed, With dual rock and flying typing, Archaeops has access to utility moves like Ally Switch, Defog, Iron Defense, Roar, Switcheroo, Taunt, and Tailwind, while getting Stab, Acrobatics, Aerial Ace, Fly, Sky Attack, as well as the powerful speed boost in Max Airstream, Head Smash, Rock Slide, Stone Edge, and Max Rockfall. Archaeops has access to powerful Stab staples both inside and outside of Dynamax. It wouldn't be uncommon to throw a Life Orb on Archaeops and take advantage of its full potential to be a mixed attacker. Archaeops has access to dank specials like Focus Blast, Heat Wave, and Dragon Pulse, but also pulls a huge array of coverage in the form of Crunch, Bulldoze, Knock Off, Earthquake, Outrage, Iron Tail, Quick Attack, Rock Smash, Shadow Claw, U-Turn, and even Zen Headbutt. Archaeops has the speed, power, and coverage to check the biggest threats in the tier when paired with our savior Weezing. I hope to see Archaeops along with other prominent fossil Pokemon make a return to Sword and Shield. Those are my picks for a Weezing-focused neutralizing gas team. If I missed anything, or if you want to add anything, leave a comment down below. If you like this kind of pokey theory content, feel free to like and subscribe. The Turn 1 Dynamax Discord has now been stood up, and I'll leave the invite down in the description. Turn 1 Dynamax is a Pokemon community for all levels of players to connect and share under one roof. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll see you all next time.